important mechanism to explain why with aging we get and start losing muscle and start losing bones is that for some reasons that we are studying here, the muscles get infiltrated by fat. So it's not the fat that is developed because of eating too much sugars. It's actually independent of that. It's just because of aging that muscles and bones become fully of fat. And more fat they accumulate, weaker they become. So one of the things that we are working here and we are recognized around the world that we do here is that analyzing what are the reasons of that fat infiltration, why this person, 85-year-old person, has more fat in the muscles and bone compared with another person, same age.
This field, it's absolutely interesting working with stem cells, adult stem cells, to differentiate them basically to many different tissues.
So we are on one of the few centers working with the stem cells. We take those stem cells and we tell them what they have to become. So we tell them you have to become fat, you have to become muscle, you have to become bone. And then we compare, you know, what do they do once they differentiate? Or sometimes we combine them, combine the fat and the bone cells, and we have discovered that they are in constant fight. So they hate each other, the fat and the bone cells. What my PhD students do is analyzing how can we prevent that fight and how can we help the bone cells to win over the fat cells.
I'm a research assistant, so I'm helping with ongoing projects. We have many projects ongoing, but mainly in the COB study project, which is the osteocalcium cells. Those cells are in frail people, in people, older people. So my job is to take the samples from those patients, healthy and donors, volunteers, and examine them and test them and try to calculate the cells, how many cells, the function of the cells in those patients' samples.
So I'm a fracture care coordinator. So I basically find all the patients who have been admitted to hospital who are over 65 who have had fractures. I basically go and see them, give them education about osteoporosis, get them onto vitamin D and calcium if they're not already taking that, and try and get them into the Fracture and Falls Clinic. It's all about, I think, as well, staying active, like, and it's got a lot to do with the mind. So if you're just willing to succumb to being old, obviously, what choice has your body got?
We have this falls and fractures clinic here. One of the things we do there is try to identify what are the factors that are predisposing people to fall and fracture. What we have developed also as part of the interventions is we have an exercise program where we retrain the patient's balance, as I mentioned before. We train the patient's strength and balance and with the exercise programs. And with that, we have demonstrated and we have published about it that patient's confidence and fear of falling, patient's confidence is improved and fear of falling is reduced.
So it's great to be able to come to a clinic where you can be assessed and then you can deal with your balance problems so that you're actually stronger and you can, you know, help your grandchildren, help be in your community better rather than being a liability.
I was here 12 months ago and they sent me to that gait and balance gym, and that I got rid of the walker. I virtually got rid of the walker and I was really on my way back. I had exercise is the key. You need the exercise, but all of the stuff that they've told me here has been immensely helpful. They've taught me a lot.
It really comes down to the team because my role is very varied and there's a lot of pressure. And I have to organise doctors and technicians, you know, for patient screening tests or patient visits. If I didn't have the team that we had, I would be drowning. and we wouldn't get anywhere because, you know, without patients, there is no research.
What we developed here with all the team is that you can see that we have nurses working with us, we have basic scientists, we have translational researchers, we have imaging people who work on x-rays and CT scans to quantify fat in the bone marrow, something that nobody else does. And how they come together, they get together at our team meeting and they share their experiences, they actually give advice to each other, despite that they come from some, you know, different backgrounds. But it's because we always look with that umbrella of interprofessional practice and education.
It's fantastic to be in a position whereby I can look after patients, take care of them, but also involved in research whereby, you know, it's clinically relevant research. That's the important thing. We're not just sort of researching things that, you know, for the sake of publishing per se, but it's things that are going to be clinically relevant that do some good for patients we look after in the future.
I think that we are paying back to the hospital, to the executive, in terms of what is the mission of a hospital is to give the best services to the community. And that's the mission that I think we're helping to accomplish, at least from a very small piece of the whole set of programs they have. At least we know that we are recognized because of our fracture prevention program are recognized not only at the local but international level.